Hello, my dear students. How are you? Hope all of you are fine. I, Rita Rani Guha, lecturer, Department of Chemistry, Milestone College. Today, I am going to take your online class because of the present critical situation. You know that. Whatever is the situation, we will always remain alert. We won't never be scared. Right? Okay. So today I am going to start chapter 7. What is the name of the chapter? Chemical reactions. The name of the chapter is chemical reactions. At first, I am going to the changes of matter. There are two types of changes in case of matter. Number one, physical change. Number two, chemical change. Physical change. Suppose water. Whenever water is in solid state, if we apply heat, it will be converted into liquid. Again, if we apply heat, that time it will be converted into gas. If we come from opposite side, if we eliminate heat from the water vapor, so that it will be converted into liquid. Again, if we eliminate heat from the liquid state of water, so that it will be converted into solid. So, what is happening over here? Only the state of matter is becoming changed. Is that clear? Only the state. Sometimes it is solid, sometimes it is liquid, sometimes it is gas. So, whenever the state of the matter is only changing, or the outlook of the matter is only changed, such type of change is known as physical change, because their percentage composition is remaining unchanged, but state is becoming changed. Such type of change is known as physical change. Then come to chemical change. Such type of change where percentage composition can be changed and fully new substance can be produced. These are called chemical change. See, whenever a candle is burning, suppose a candle is burning. Well, you know, whenever it is a candle, it is remaining as solid state. Whenever it is burning, the candle, the wax is melting and falling by this way. This is the liquid state of wax and this is the solid state. So what kind of change this one? This one is physical change. After melting, whenever they are becoming deposited on the bottom portion, again they are converted into wax. So here this one is the raw material of candle is wax, here this one is also wax. Only their shape is becoming changed. Such type of change is known as physical change. But whenever candle is burned, that time you know that candle is actually, the raw material of candle is hydrocarbon. Whenever hydrocarbon is burned in oxygen, that time it can produce carbon dioxide plus water. See, in this case, after this change, it is becoming, the whole substance is becoming changed. That means such type of change is permanent and physical change is temporary. That means permanently they are changing. This kind of change is known as chemical change. So in case of, we may get a question that show that in case of wax, physical and chemical, both type of changes can be found. That time you will explain in this way that here it is showing physical change and here it is showing chemical change. Is that clear? Okay. Then come to chemical reaction. What is chemical reaction? Whenever two or more than two substances combine together and produce a new substance is known as, produce fully new substance is known as chemical reaction. All the chemical reactions can be classified into some of the groups. but there are lots of reaction. How can we classify them? That's why we have considered, scientists have considered some of the factors, and according to the factors all the reactions have been classified. Factor number 1 or number 1, direction of chemical reaction. According to the direction of chemical reaction, all the reactions have been classified into two types. Suppose irreversible reaction. In case of a reaction, only reactants are converted into product. Such type of reaction is known as irreversible reaction. That means the reaction is one-way reaction. Only the reactants are converted into product. This is called irreversible reaction. Suppose calcium carbonate. Whenever calcium carbonate is heated in an open container, that time calcium oxide and carbon dioxide can be produced. As the container is opened, just after producing carbon dioxide will happen? Carbon dioxide will go away, because carbon dioxide is a gas. Carbon dioxide will be evaporated, or carbon dioxide will be vaporized. And whenever same reaction is done in a closed container, that time calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide can be produced. But as the container is closed, that time carbon dioxide and calcium oxide is remaining, both are remaining inside the container. Carbon dioxide is not going away. Again, calcium oxide and carbon dioxide are reacting with each other and coming back to the reactant. Such type of reactions are known as reversible reaction, because in this case reactants are converted into product, products are converted into reactant. Whenever in case of a reversible reaction, reactants are converted into product, this type of reaction is known as forward reaction. In case of forward reaction, arrow is started from the reactant and finished towards the product. And backward reaction, the arrow will start from the product and will be finished towards the reactant. This one is known as backward reaction. That means a reversible reaction has two parts, forward reaction and backward reaction. And same reaction can act as reversible and irreversible in both situations, according to the situation. Same reaction is showing two characters. Sometimes it is irreversible, sometimes it is irreversible. When it is in open container, it is irreversible. When it is in closed container, that time it is reversible reaction. Is that clear? So according to the direction of chemical reaction, chemical reactions have been classified into two types. These two types, reversible and irreversible. Now, characteristics number 2, heat change of chemical reaction. You know that in some of the cases, in case of reaction, heat can be produced and sometimes it can be absorbed. Whenever heat is produced in any reaction, that time such type of reaction is known as exothermic reaction. Suppose nitrogen plus hydrogen is reacting with each other. In presence of iron powder, one molecule of nitrogen is combining with 3 molecules of hydrogen and producing ammonia. This reaction is known as Haber-Bosch process of industrialization of ammonia. In this case, 92 kilojoule heat is produced. That's why this type of reaction is known as exothermic reaction. Now come to endothermic reaction. Such type of reaction where heat is absorbed is known as endothermic reaction. Whenever nitrogen is reacting with oxygen, it is producing nitric oxide. In this case, 180 kilojoule heat is absorbed. Such type of reaction is known as endothermic reaction. In case of endothermic reaction, the value of del H is positive, and in case of exothermic reaction, the value of del H is negative. Okay. Dear learners, I discussed already about the two characteristics according to which reactions have been classified. Characteristics number 3. According to electron transfer, all the reactions have been classified into two types, redox and non-redox. Redox, this word has come from two words. Reduction plus oxidation. Red has come from reduction and ox has come from oxidation. So, from reduction and oxidation, redox, this word has come. Reduction is such type of reaction where reception or accept of electron, any atom or radical or ion accept electron, that time is known as reduction reaction. And whenever any atom, radical or ion donate electron, that time it is known as oxidation. I will discuss about reduction and oxidation in details later on. Now, at first, let me discuss the classification of redox reaction. Redox reaction, you can define in another way also. When transfer of electron take place, according to the transfer of electron, when transfer of electron take place is known as redox reaction. Example of redox reaction, addition reaction. Number 1, addition reaction. Here, ferrous chloride is reacting with chlorine and producing ferric chloride. Here, chlorine is added with ferrous chloride. That's why it is known as addition reaction. Decomposition reaction. Whenever a compound is broken down into two or more than two molecules or elements is known as decomposition. Here, phosphorus pentachloride is broken down into phosphorus trichloride plus chlorine. This type of reaction is known as decomposition reaction. So, can't I say that decomposition reaction and addition reaction are opposite of each other? Here, two or more than two compounds are added together, and here one big molecule is broken down into small molecules, so that addition and decomposition are fully opposite of each other. Now come to substitution reaction. Substitution reaction, see here, zinc is reacting with sulfuric acid and producing zinc sulfate plus hydrogen. That means zinc is replacing in the place of hydrogen. That means hydrogen is replaced by zinc. Such type of reaction is known as substitution reaction. That means whenever any substance is replaced by another substance or displaced by another substance is known as substitution reaction or displacement reaction. Now come to combustion reaction. Whenever any substance is burnt in oxygen and produce oxide is known as combustion reaction. Here, methane is burnt in oxygen and producing carbon dioxide plus water is known as combustion reaction. In this reaction, heat is produced. So, whenever heat is produced, such type of reaction is known as what? Exothermic reaction. Is that clear? So, these all are the example of redox reaction. What is redox reaction? That means in case of addition reaction, in case of decomposition reaction, in case of substitution reaction, in case of combustion reaction, In all of the cases, transfer of electron is taking place. Do you wanna see the proof? Okay, I will show you the proof later on after discussing non-redox. Okay, non-redox reaction. Example, non-redox. What is non-redox reaction? Whenever no transfer of electron take place, is known as non-redox reaction. Example of non-redox reaction. Number one, neutralization. Number two, precipitation. These are the example of non-redox reaction. Now come to neutralization reaction. Whenever acid is reacting with base, it is producing salt and water. HCl hydrochloric acid is reacting with sodium hydroxide and producing sodium chloride plus water. Sodium chloride plus water is known as neutralization reaction. That means in this case acid is neutralized by base. Acid is losing its acidity and it is losing its alkalinity. That means both are neutralized by each other. Such type of reaction is known as neutralization reaction. Then come to precipitation reaction. Whenever, what is the definition of precipitation reaction? Whenever two substances is separately soluble in water. Listen carefully, students. Whenever two different substances are separately soluble in water, but whenever they are taken together, they are not soluble fully in each other. In this case, sodium chloride is soluble in water. Water is a solvent. And silver nitrate is also soluble in water. But whenever we are taking sodium chloride and silver nitrate together, that time silver chloride and sodium nitrate is producing. And a white colored precipitate can be found. Now you can ask me, that means what is precipitate? Precipitate means if you perform this reaction in a test tube, if you take the solution of sodium chloride with the solution of silver nitrate, see here I have written aqueous, that means water is mixed up both with both of them, that time a white colored sediment can be found at the bottom portion of the test tube. It is because of the creating of silver chloride. Such type of reaction is known as precipitation reaction, and in this case silver chloride is precipitate and sodium nitrate also produced. Here sodium and nitrate is remaining in this way. They are not reacting with any other substance. In this case, sodium ion and nitrate ion is known as spectator ion or visitor ion. Now, whatever I have discussed, you may get some of the knowledge based or comprehensive question. Suppose, just now I told you spectator ion or visitor ion. What do you mean by visitor ion? Number two, what is substitution reaction? Number three, what is combustion reaction? If you get the question, what do you mean by visitor ion? That time you have to say such type of ion which doesn't participate in the reaction is known as visitor ion or spectator ion. what is substitution reaction? Such type of reaction in which one substance is replaced by another substance. Such type of reaction is known as substitution reaction or displacement reaction. What is combustion reaction? So, how will you say this one? Whenever any substance is burnt in oxygen, is known as combustion reaction. Is that clear to you? Okay. Today up to this, at the next class, I will discuss about different topics. So, up to this, bye. Thank you.